Magandang araw, kapamilya. Welcome to Journeys of Hope. And as we've been discussing the last weekends, we're reflecting now on the past elections. And we'd like to take a look at really during this, maybe another weekend after this, I'd like to take a look at what the youth felt, no, in terms of their being involved in this electoral process. So for this weekend, we have as our guests, actually kasama ko sila sa, we have this, as I mentioned in my mass, we have this weekly Sunday reflection live stream, ano? I think that's what it's called, live streaming in Kumu. And they are two of the three co-hosts that I have. Unfortunately, our female co-host would not be able to join us today. We think she's busy because she also works in Enchanted Kingdom. She's actually a talent, an actress, if you wish, a performer. So we'd like to welcome and we'd like to thank them for joining us to share their experience on, of course, Election Day, but also during the entire campaign period, what as part of the youth sector, what was their experience? So we'd like to welcome one of our co-hosts in Kumustahan with Father Tito in Kumu every Sunday, Claudio Lopa. And then also we'd like to welcome the other co-host, Dan Yotoko. So welcome, Claudio and Dan.
Thank you, Fads. Thanks for having us.
No, thank you for joining. Thank you for joining this weekend. So, again, no, sanay naman tayo magkwentuhan, no? But I wonder if we should give a joke at the end of this episode, no?
Okay.
I think it's like, necessary.
No matter what show, dapat may joke talaga.
Dapat may joke. Okay. Mm-hmm. Then, just to get our viewers up to date, in Kumustahan kasi, we end the show, that's 11:30 to 12:30 every Sunday. We actually reflect on the gospel, the four of us, no, including Aliana. And sometimes Direk Alco Guerrero would join us. Mm. And at the end of the show, I would always end it with a joke. No? Of course, we'll see. Anyway, you know this last campaign period in elections has been very interesting, no? And maybe you can share from the perspective of the youth, no? Ano ba yung perspective niyo during these last elections?
Ako, can I go first?
Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
I think the experience of the youth, the experience of a first-time voter, I think, as a first-time voter, grabe talaga yung pakiramdam na naranasan ko these past few weeks, actually this month talaga. Like, di ako makatulog because of anxiety sa halalan, and I think it in a way it was a good anxiety because doon ko talaga naranasan just how much I love the Philippines and how much I want what's best for the country. Yung parang everyday tutok ako sa news, ano ba yung nangyayari. And as someone, as a first time voter, I could definitely say na iba yung feeling when you finally do have quote unquote a voice when it comes to choosing your leaders. Kasi last 6 years ago, I was 17 when the elections took place in 2016. So back then, I always had a very, I guess short term view when it came to politics or elections. Like I was very passive, kumbaga, because I didn't have like the power to vote yet, or I didn't feel like my voice mattered. And everything changed this year, actually, even since last year when I finally registered to be a voter. Parang doon ko talaga na realize na iba pala yung feeling when you're so involved in this, and you realize na after going out to many events and gatherings and whatnot, na you know the what you vote for isn't just for yourself, eh? Who you vote for isn't for yourself, it's for everyone. And I think that I experienced that firsthand talaga these elections, just how much important it is in long term for everyone talaga to vote, because your vote doesn't affect yourself, it affects everyone else around you. And I think I'm happy na I experienced that this year and last year, and that I'm not anymore a passive listener or advocate when it comes to politics. Kasi I recently learned lang like last year lang just how much politics or even elections is embedded into our daily activities, and how much we should really pay attention to it. Kasi important yun because everything is politics. Like that's what I learned growing up, eh. And what I've learned over the years and months, na everything we do talaga does affect the people around us. So as a first-time voter, it was an overwhelming, but in a good way, an overwhelming talaga of sense of responsibility rin.
That's my question. No? I thank you for that beautiful sharing. Was being a first-time voter a major factor in your own reflection?
In my own reflection, it did. Because I feel like back then, I felt like whenever I'd listen to the elections or whenever I would see people voting, I always thought, ano ba yung point? Na parang isa ka lang naman, di ba? Parang wala namang kwenta yung vote mo kasi out of the millions and millions and millions. And then I realized as a first-time voter na the influence na you have with your friends and your peers and your family, those matter. Diba? And I realized din na as a first-time voter na it did play a part because it allowed me to realize na yung decision ko na bumoto, right, for a local or a national leader affects how I want what's best for my community and the people around me. So dun lumaki yung mindset ko or naging malawak yung understanding ko na why voting is important. And I think being a first-time voter did affect that, Fads, because it made me realize na my voice, I'm not speaking for myself, but I'm speaking also for those kids, diba, in the streets or people in my subdivision, people outside my subdivision, or people in my barangay, diba, na mas nagiging parang mas nagiging accountable ako when it came to like choosing, because I wasn't just choosing for myself. And I think that's why it played a big part when I realized the weight na it carried yung na sa boto ko this elections.
Yeah. Well, thank you. That's a very inspiring perspective, actually, no? So, Claudio, how many times have you voted, Claudio?
So, this is my second national elections, but it's my third time voting. And my experience was similar to Dan's. Yung na-inspire ka kasi nakikita mo din yung mga tao sa paligid na naging politically aware bigla. No matter who they're voting for. I don't count Facebook. Facebook is the den of trolls. But see, like when you're in a group chat of your old batchmates, di ba, or your old classmates, na yung mga tahimik dati, parang ngayon meron silang sasabihin. That for me was already very inspiring because I like engaging in these conversations with people. Mm-hmm. Even if we have differing political views, we support different candidates, I still appreciated those conversations. So in that sense, I did feel that sense of inspiration. I also felt that same sense of responsibility that Dan was talking about. Mm-hmm. Diba parang you're driving around in a car na may sticker ng kandidato mo, tapos may hihingi ng pera sa'yo or may hihingi ng pagkain sa'yo. Tapos, I don't know, like, it just carries a certain, like, you know, I want these people to know that someone who, like, supports the candidate I support, kami mamimigay kami kung kahit anong kaya namin ibigay.
That's a good
diba?
Point.
Kahit diba? Pagkain parang lang, kahit 20 lang.
Kahit pagkain, diba? Diba? Hindi lang campaign materials, diba? Hindi lang nagbibigay ng baller. Hindi naman nila pwede kainin ng baller, diba? So, parang I became more conscious to have food in my car, sky flakes in my car para mamigay or something like that. Those small things became more evident. And then after the elections, parang when everything was said and done, it occurred to me that this attitude should not just be during the elections. This attitude should not be linked to the candidate that I was supporting. It should be my attitude towards my countrymen also. So parang there was another sense of nationalism or of patriotism. I don't know what to call it. Something for my fellow countrymen.
Or just just a civic responsibility. Diba?
Yes, that's it. That's the perfect responsibility. That's the perfect term, Fad. Civic. I've suddenly felt a civic responsibility to be consistent with how I think about my actions affecting my fellow Filipinos.
Yeah, and then also I would think na correct me if I'm wrong, no? You were acting that way because you felt that was what your candidate stood for, diba?
Yes, what they espouse.
So I guess that's wow, this is very interesting. Very interesting insights from the two of you, no? How I wish Aliana was here, but anyway, we can...
Me too.
Follow
up na lang natin sa Sunday.
Follow up natin sa Sunday, yeah, correct. Okay, now this is the other interesting thing, no? Kasi I remember at a certain point during our conversation, I think we were talking about also the experience, your experiences of registration, di ba? Sila Dan, they were talking about that, di ba? And Aliana, I remember, di ba? Aliana rin was sharing with us in one time how you went through the registration process, no? Are you one of those, Dan, na talagang pumila? Could you share that? And then after that, Claudio, did you need to reactivate? No. Ako hindi ako nag-activate.
No more because I had voted in the last
year. After Dan shares his experience of trying to register, let's talk about election day itself. How you went through election.
Sure. Okay.
Dan, go ahead. Registration experience.
Alam mo, sir, my registration experience proved to me na kung kaya ko mag-antay para mag-register, kaya ko mag-antay para sa future jowa ko. Kasi ang tagal. Sobrang tagal, guys, ng pag-antay ko. Because my experience was very, very, I don't even want to say unique, it was very unfortunate. It was sobrang saklap ng experience ko. Kasi dalawang beses akong na-cut off before my third attempt.
Oh my god. Yeah,
that's right.
I remember kumento ko yung guys sa Kumustahan. Na sobrang saklap kasi two times I registered sa Eastwood because I live near the area, and that was sa QC. You could only go in QC kasi you could only go to your districts, right? Mm-hmm. And so my district was in Eastwood City, so mall siya, right? Mall, and so doon ako nag-line up. First time, kala ko, okay, if I'm about like 5 a.m., baka may chance pa. I went there 5 a.m. After 3 hours of movement, I was cut right in front of the door leading to the escalator going up. Tapos sabi ng guard sa akin, sir, sorry po, pero na rin siya, tutama yung limit namin. Balik na lang po kayo, blue pass.
Oh my God.
So the first time. Second time naman, 4 o'clock, I thought for sure I was gonna...
4 a.m.
And same Grabe. Thing happened ulit. But my fault there was that was during the, di ba they extended the vote, the
window. Yeah.
That was the last day of before they extended. That was quote unquote the last day. So my fault was not expecting. Now of course since it's the last day, more people would.
Dadami yung tao.
Yeah.
Thankfully nga, and of course, like I knew naman they were gonna extend kasi so many people weren't able to vote. So parang when they extended, sabi ko, okay, I'm gonna make sure pipila ako sa kalagitnaan ng extension date. Like on like a Wednesday or a Tuesday. And I'm gonna make sure alas 12 pala na umaga nandun ako. Alas 12 pala na umaga nandun ako. So I lined up, I woke up, right? At 2 a.m. lined up there. And the funny thing is, when after waiting for like 5 hours, I brought like a neck pillow pa nga, nagbilang neck pillow, kasi I knew that I was gonna be there until like 9 a.m. lang. The funny thing is, when I got my queuing number, I was number 50 or like 55. Imagine mo, 2 a.m., pa 55 pa ako doon, hindi pa ako yung I was like first 10, first 20.
Yeah.
To be honest, lads, in a way, that made me, that started actually, that feeling of like what Klaus said, being accountable and having that sense of responsibility. Kasi doon ko talaga nakita just how many people na first-time voters na do want to vote.
Yeah.
That want to have their voice heard. And in a way, it made me hopeful din na even though whether or not the results that we wanted came out or not, now we are heading into that right direction of, okay, people do want to be heard. Diba?
Yeah.
Diba? Like there is that step in the youth wanting talaga to have an impact. And nakita ko yun kasi sobrang dami mga first time voters na nag-register na sobrang aga nila sa na pumila, na hindi pa kumakain or nagko-commute or was there or would retry like I did. Try and try again para lang makaregister.
Yeah. Galing.
So for me, fans, kahit sobrang hirap, sobrang tagal, sobrang init. In a way, the lesson that I picked up was I'm in the right track then because I am one of those people that refuses to not have a voice. yeah. And the same thing, ako din yung tipong na naranasan ko rin dun at that particular moment na it is now more important than ever to not only be responsible for my vote, but also in a way to act like a responsible citizen then, because in the, at the end of the day,
it's a sense of civic duty, no? Yeah, responsibility. Yeah. Okay, now let's talk about, since si Claudio hindi naman siya nag-register na kasi third voting na niya. Your experience naman on election day, voting. Ako, I'll share my experience, no? Senior citizen ako. I think I shared this in the previous two episodes ago, no? I'm senior citizen, so I had a special line, ano? But it took me 45 minutes pa rin, ano? And then I have some friends that I saw. I went at around 10 o'clock, eh. 10 o'clock, 10, mga ganun when I arrived. Pero meron akong mga kapitbahay, mga kaibigan, they were there since 8. And then, nung lumabas ako ng 11 o'clock, malapit pa lang sila dun sa makapasok sa building, no? But you spend another maybe 10-15 minutes inside the building kasi you go to a room and then before you go to the polling place. No? So that was my experience, which is very pleasant, no? Kasi mabait yung mga tao, ang daming tumutulong. And, you know, again, wala kang sense of inept. Kasi I think you're looking forward to vote. Eh. So ako, I was ready to wait for mga 2 hours. No? Ako, ready na ako mag-wait. Eh. Kaya, pero it took me just 45 minutes. And there was no amount of, turn ko na ba? So I was really willing to wait also. No? So what was your experience during election day?
Well, I was one of those that had to wait.
Wait, kayo ba yung presinto that you had to wait in the football field or something? Or
yeah.
Okay, let's say where, but I heard about that.
Yeah. So what happened was my I live beside my lola and my tita, and my tita who's registered to vote, my lola not anymore. She left at 6 a.m. and then she's PWD, so she was able to get priority. Pero yung mga kasambahay namin na sumama sa kanya, humintay ng mga 4 na oras, 5 oras. So, I was mentally preparing myself. Naalala ko pa nung vaccine ko, second dose, 6 hours ako naghintay sa bilad sa araw. So, I was like, okay, whatever, you know, anything, just so I can vote. Anything so I can vote. But the frustrating part for me was that it was only my precinct's line or my cluster's line. So, pati yung mga hindi priority na ibang cluster, mas mabilis yung galaw ng linya nila. So, napikon talaga ako. As in, I saw pa my friend in line. Pagpasok mo na ng balota, he was beside me pa. I said, uy, bro, oh, how long did you wait, bro? Kasi ako, 4.5 hours. He goes, 15 minutes. I wanted to tear my hair out of my scalp.
Oh my God, sobrang mamalas. Ang malas talaga.
Pero lang din kasi bagong lipat din kami ng precinct. We used to vote in the old province where we live. And then we moved na here to, where we are now. Because it was too inconvenient. We would have to drive pa mga 3 hours to get to our previous voting precinct. So, my suspicion is yung mga bagong register, tsaka yung mga bagong lipat ng precinct na na group sa isang cluster. Ang tagal. Ang tagal talaga. That just goes to show there's still a lot of inefficiencies in a basic process such as lining up. Parang hindi man lang sila gumawa ng separate voting area para sa PWD at senior citizen, para sa priority. Yeah. Yung ginawa na lang nila, pagdating ng priority, ipapakat nila sa line. So, hihinto yung line mo. And then you're gonna wait na lang for however long. Tsaka kung, in waves sila, kung ibig sabihin, 20, di ba? Parang 20 people arrive. Hindi naman pwede na pahihintayin mo ng 10 tapos ipapavote mo ng 10. So, they have to let all through. So, that was really a cause of inefficiency. But, at the end of the day, I'm just glad it didn't rain. because we were out in the open.
Meron pa ako nakitang picture, sunburn, grabe.
Yeah, my sunburn was sunburn, of my of my mask again. Dati sa mga rally, kung kinukuha yun, tas sa voting ulit.
Ay, ikaw, Dan, what was your experience, Dan, of the ano?
Actually, fans, I feel like I'm one of those friends na Claudio would have teared his hair on if he saw me. Kasi ang bilis din sa akin. I was fortunate enough.
Must be nice.
I was fortunate enough, fans. Kasi one, sabi ko sa sarili ko, okay, easy ako na maaga. Gusto ko gumising ako na maaga. As in, alas 5 pa lang, gising na ako. Kasi gusto ko, pagdating na alas 6, nandun na ako sa pila. And that was my plan. I was like, okay, I'm gonna expect na it won't be easy. It'll probably be an hour. Because, or 2 hours at most. But fortunately enough, I guess it's a testament then to my barangay and where I was, right? Because it was the process in where I voted was very smooth. They had the PWD line, a line for mga non-priority, and then at the same time, they had like marshals who would escort you to the proper ano.
And yan dapat.
Oh, yeah, proper yeah. Proper waiting area. Mas may waiting area tapos may voting area. So dun ka, and yung waiting area it's hindi siya field. So kwarto siya. Diba? So, but so for me, Fad, same with you. 45 minutes. Around 40.
Oh, okay. Hindi hour. Alam mo Dan, ano yan? Naawa ang Diyos sa'yo dahil tatlong beses ka nag-attempt mag-register. So God said, okay, I'll spare you this time.
Alam mo, parang if you combine the times I've waited, 12 hours na rin yun eh. So parang sabi ko, sige. I've suffered enough. I've suffered enough na.
Punta ka na.
Punta na ako.
So, okay. Sorry. Go ahead, Dan. Go ahead.
I was gonna say, yun nga, sabi ko nga, ano na, I think it's also a matter din of, ano, of hopefully in the next elections nga na, you have 6 years to prepare. So I hope naman na at least yung mga districts and cities around NCR and even across the Philippines. So na, kaya ba ano, have like a system in place, di ba? Kasi yeah, kung kaya ng systems sa district or sa district mo, fans, di ba? Why can other barangay also, right? So it's a matter of trying to streamline
the organization.
Organization para, you know, we have less ano, chance of like, you know, sunburn.
Okay, so we're down to our last 7 minutes.
Okay,
coming from that experience of voting, ano, number one, how it felt after you voted, and but now, of course, we know the results, no? But how you feel now, no? Ano yung hope ninyo? Kasi ako, after I voted, I was happy, no? Parang I exercised my civic duty. And I was hopeful, no? And then after that, of course, things, you know, once lumabas yung results, but ako na, I'm still hopeful, no? I have my own hopes now. So where are you at this point, no? Kasi especially from the perspective of the youth, no? You are part of that population of the youth, no? So, okay, shoot. We have we're down to 7 minutes.
I think I mentioned in Kumustahan last week na how my perspective has been. Kasi if you go online, especially depending on who you voted for, toxic pa rin eh, you know? And it's not good. So, yung naging perspective ko na lang is, mag-pull na lang. Diba? Parang may trabaho naman kailangan gawin, so gawin na lang natin. And I totally understand people who are angry, who are sad based on the results, and who and they're valid. Those feelings are valid, and those people are allowed to process their grief, so to speak, in whatever way they want. Pero ako, my choice is, if you want somebody to help lift you up a bit, ako, I'll be that guy, diba? I want to help lift people up. I want them to know that the work that has to be done in the Philippines doesn't end with who's elected president. It doesn't end with 6 years either. Mm-hmm. This is going to be constant work for a better future that we might not even live to see. Mm-hmm. So my perspective is kind of like a re-energized version of how I felt before I cast my vote. I casted my vote, which is I want to inspire people to continue with the movement. There have been so many political awakenings and so many social movements that have grown from this campaign period alone that I think have the potential to really grow into impactful movements, you know, mm-hmm. into things that can make lasting change. Yeah. So for me, my perspective is, even though I'm seeing a lot of grief around me, I'm seeing a lot of anger, and I'm seeing a lot of divide between mm-hmm. Filipinos, whether it's online or even just in the way that we interact with each other, I still believe that there's beauty here in the Philippines, you know? Like, I'm definitely not one of those that wants to leave. And I'm definitely not one of those who is telling people to leave because there's nothing here for them. I think that there is still so much that can be done. The amount of time that the Philippines has been around is just a blip in the amount of time that we may continue to live and thrive.
I think, Claudio, but people have to realize we're a very young nation.
Yes,
we're very a very young nation. I think, in terms of nationhood, that's another topic altogether. No, we're barely 100. No, really, in terms of nationhood. No, thank you. How nice. Very nice. Thank you. Dan.
Grabe, I mean, like that what Klaus said took the words out of my mouth in terms of, especially the part when he was talking about yung divide with people and telling people to leave, or people not saying that there's nothing for you here. Ako kasi for me, after the election results came out, like whether or not your candidate won, para sa akin, the efforts I've seen the youth do during these elections, the volunteering, the doing their part to help out in their communities, for me, that gave me hope. Despite what happened on the elections, despite whether or not the results that came out were to my liking or preference. Kasi para sa akin, it's not if the candidate that I chose won, but it's what do I feel about being a Filipino. It's so funny because I think it's a good way to end. And I remember I had a professor from UAN, from my school, my alma mater, UANP, and I will never forget his statement during the elections. Na him being a Filipino, it's not incumbent on who is going to be seated on Malacanang. And he told me that he posted that whatever you feel about the country, whether it's extreme pain, extreme joy, or extreme confusion, is equal to how much you love the Philippines. Because the more emotions you have towards your country, whether positive or negative, it all just leads to na sobrang mahal mo yung bansa mo. Or talagang minamahal mo yung Pilipinas. And for me, that resonated with me talaga eh. Na whether or not you're feeling extremely happy or extremely
down
or down, right? Yeah. It just speaks volumes to how much you love the country. And I think that's something we should always keep in our hearts and keep into mind. Na it's because we love our country that we feel this way.
Yes, but
it's
because we love
the people around us that we feel the need to stand for truth and justice and righteousness. And I think that's something that I will always carry after this election, and why I am definitely one of those people na I don't want to leave the Philippines. I don't want to tell people to leave because there's so much here na that could be greater if we just worked harder and listened better. Diba? So I think that's how
nice.
I
would end.
Because that's something that
that's so great, Dan.
Yeah, very nice. Thank you very much. I mean, I really appreciate hearing that from the two of you, no? Having said that, wag na tayo mag-joke, baka mawala yung credibility nung sinabi. We can leave that to Kumustahan on Kumu. So, but again,
if you want the joke.
Yeah, 11:30 in Kumu, in FYE station. It's an ABS station also, no? Again, Clau, Dan, thank you very much. I mean, I think we should talk more about this, and there's so much to do, no? I also agree with you. There's so much to do. We have a nation to build, no? So thank you very much. And thank you to, maraming salamat to everyone. And please join us again next week. We will continue to hear the voices of the youth on their experience of the past campaign period and the elections. Thank you.